Hey everyone. I hope you're doing well. Just give me a second. Just in case you're wondering, this is a citronella candle. Supposed to help with keeping bugs away. It does an okay job. I guess it depends on how many that you have lit. So, I have my in-ear binaural microphones. And just so you can pick up the 3D true binaural sound around me. There's two big oak trees flanking me either side out of view, and hopefully you can hear the wind. It's a very cool evening. It's about I think it's about in the 60s. It was very hot today, and then a brief storm came. Temperatures kind of dropped here this evening. Sky looks not too clear. I mean, I can't see anything, but there's a couple of bright stars I can make out, so definitely some clouds up there. So, I'm looking at light, the single light that's lighting up the deck out here. I mean, it's a wooden deck. And just very, very, with the breeze and the cool air, could fall asleep out here. So I thought, make for a perfect let's talk. Haven't done one of those in about a year at least, especially since starting up the podcast. And I'm going to get into the topic of the video in a little bit. I'm just looking at some of the little critters that have a lot of beetles, some moths, and I'll show you a little clip here. You can see them just flying around a little bit. Really need to get a cover for that one bulb, but anywho, so I hope you've been well. I hope life is treating you well. If not, I hope things turn around for you sooner than later. But if you're in a certain situation, that's where that may not be possible. I hope you can find some solace, some happiness, some peace, peace of mind, some serenity. Thank you for joining me, by the way. So yeah, it's just a very chill night. I thought it'd make for a good little video. Maybe put you to sleep, if anything. Podcast is on a little bit of a hiatus because I find myself spreading myself too thin creatively. So when I go to do the podcast, it takes a lot of creative energy out of me and kind of disrupts the flow of what I like to do here with the channel. So, you know, we'll see how it works out. Kind of ebb and flow. I was going to eat something, but since I do a lot of eating in some videos lately, I thought I would put the kibosh on that for this session at least. My stomach is a little growling a little bit. I love food. Just gotta be careful with sugar and cholesterol, especially as I get older. Catches up to you. And sugar is a hard habit to break. It's in everything. I sure love Twizzlers and ice cream and cake, but I try to eat that during the day. Still have dessert at night. You can hear that, the wind up in the trees. Those trees are about 4 to 5 stories high. Yeah. 40 feet tall, 50 feet, something like that. I was never good at judging heights like that. I'll try to show you a clip of the trees lit up here with the porch light on. I always like that look at the trees at night, lit up. A little spooky, but it's all good. So, that's really it for the environment here. So the title of this video, and like I said, you'll have to excuse my stomach. The title of this video Life Itself Has No Rules. Something I touched upon before. And I didn't specifically come out or plan this video. Like most of my videos, I like to go be in the moment. I was planning on I'm still planning on the Bloodborne video, but I need to obtain some period clothing. I need some Renaissance clothing for that. I was going to do a behind the scenes video of how I make my ASMR videos. And I still plan that. I just need a second tripod. because I want to show you how I set up with one, my little camcorder, and then use this camera to show you the, it'll be split screen a little bit. As I actually turn the camera on and everything. I was going to do Charlie Carl. I wasn't really feeling that, so I'm going to get to him. There's a new character that's going to explain a lot of the Rift lore, Arkham Sanitarium. And I'm thinking about a gaming channel. But again, I don't want to spread myself too thin. I have freed up some time. It's about time, so I'm kind of happy about that. It's been a long time coming. But, so, the title of this video. So let me tell you how this video came about. So I was deciding on what video to make today, tonight. We came out here to play some cards, Uno to be exact, right here. Myself, my wife, our son. And it was cool, almost like a sweatshirt, a hoodie kind of weather. I said, you know what? I think I'll do a let's talk. I saw some folks comment asking if I could do one recently, and I still read all the comments. Still read all the messages. I don't have time to get to them anymore, like I would like. I'm sure you all understand that. So I was thinking about video, and during the course of the day, I was also thinking about how crazy life is. I don't know if there was a quote or a meme thrown around about welcome to the madhouse, we're all crazy here. And I was thinking, you know, along those lines. I was thinking about how life probably plays a huge part, or is the part or key factor into a lot of issues that we have, that folks have. You know, aside from accidents and things like that, I'm talking more mental health. If you hear a little machine kick on, it's somebody's central air. If you're not it's outside compressor. So I was thinking about that. And then a couple hours, somewhere about an hour or so as we were getting ready for dinner. Excuse me. I picked up Carl Jung's Red Book. Now, I didn't bring this out here to show this off, right? I'm not like that at all. It's been a while since I've done anything with Carl Jung. It's been a while since, it's been months since I've picked this up. and I'm not much of a spiritual guy. I do give credence to things that we can't explain. I'm not one of those folks that, you know, if you're a Christian, if you're a Buddhist, if you're spiritual, hey, that's great. I don't think anything less of you. Some things I disagree with, Christianity. But who am I to tell anyone what they want to believe? I don't want to get into all that. But anyway, I picked the book up, and I believe a little bit in synchronicity. Things happen for a reason. I think a lot of things have happened in my life, and I would bet your life too, seem a little bit too much coincidental to be just random act. I think, you know, like I said, I'm a logical guy. I don't believe in ghosts, but maybe there are ghosts. I don't really know about multi-dimensions, string theories. But I give credence to things because we just don't know. Right? We're human beings using human science to try to understand a world that was not created, a universe that was not created by humans. We were born from the primordial stew that was the Earth billions of years ago when first signs of life began to crawl around. That's where we came from. And we're trying to understand it. Understand a world, a universe that I don't think we'll ever understand. Who knows? Anyway. So off and on throughout the day, a couple times I was thinking about that. Welcome to the madhouse. Drawn to this book. And I don't want to make too much of a big deal out of it. Like, it's like, you know, oh my gosh, this is, I can't believe this happened. This is like a big moment, but things are just strange, you know? And I love it. I don't know what page it is, but just give me a few moments here to find it. Right, this book looks pretty huge, but it's about two hands length and size. Obvious innuendos there. See if I can find this here. I have not read this book in a while. I have not read the whole thing. I think I'm close here. Just bear with me as I try to find the page. I flipped open to. I didn't flip open to it, but I paged through, and then I just came to this page, and I was just like, how coincidental. My train of thought. So, just bear with me, folks. My friends, if I can call you my friend. Not in the strict form, strict of the sense, the strict term, whatever. Watch, I'm not going to be able to find it. I might not be in the right chapter, but hey, right? I'm getting a little ASMR here as I flip through the pages. Maybe that works too. Okay, I may be a little too far ahead. So, let's just go back a little further. Here we go. I think I'm in the right spot. I even forget the title, chapter. I posted it on my Facebook page. I should actually... and Instagram. Here we go. So, let's see what section of the Red Book this is. What part of Carl Jung's phase of his life, or when he wrote this, what you might call the whole section here. Okay, Liber Secundus. I think that's how you pronounce it. So, just flipping through, I came to this, not, you know, I didn't spend an hour and then finally come to it, but, you know, this is my life. It's just, you know, life is strange, like that video game. So section here, Nox Tertia, N-O-X, next word is T-E-R-T-I-A. I'm going to say it's Tertia. Third night, based on the footnote. January 18th, 1914. And here we are. Let me see. There's an annotation here. There's a footnote here. Labeled 192, and I just want to read you off the footnote, but I don't know where that 192 comes into play. I see 191, I see 193. Okay, 192. Okay. Alright. So. Alright, this is in quotes. Oh no, this is not in quotes, actually. So we're talking about... we're all crazy here, right? Welcome to the madhouse, right? Throw a lot of these quotes around, and sometimes we think we're crazy, you know, all this, right? Who's sane, who's not sane? What is sanity? My soul spoke to me in a whisper. Urgently and alarmingly, quote, words, words, do not make too many words. Be silent and listen. Have you recognized your madness, and do you admit it? Have you noticed that all your foundations are completely mired in madness? Do you not want to recognize your madness and welcome it in a friendly manner? You wanted it to accept everything, so accept madness too. Let the light of your madness shine, and it will suddenly dawn on you. Madness is not to be despised and not to be feared, but instead you should give it life, end quote. And then it says I, colon, and I believe this is I, as in Carl Jung. And then there's an S, which is probably his soul. I'm sure there's a part here that explains that is how he's talking. I'm not sure how far the I and the S goes back here, but okay. So I'm going to say that's how it is. So Carl Jung saying, your words sound hard, and the task you set me is difficult. If you want his soul, if you want to find paths, you should also not spurn madness, since it makes up such a great part of your nature. I didn't know that this is so. Be glad that you can recognize it, for you will thus avoid becoming its victim. See, right there. you can recognize that maybe there's something about us that we're self-awareness. Not that we're crazy, but we can admit that maybe we are, we can think about maybe we are crazy. Maybe there's something about us, you know, not necessarily schizophrenia, create that kind of, I don't want to even say that's crazy, that's not crazy, that's just a condition. And I don't really want to throw around the word crazy, but madness. The stuff that drives creative individuals to do what they do, that some of the things that we do. You know, we say, what am I crazy? Was I crazy when I did that, right? There's a madness inside of us. Be glad that you can recognize it, for you will thus avoid becoming victim to madness. Madness is a special form of the spirit and clings to all teachings and philosophies, but even more to daily life, since life itself is full of craziness and at bottom, utterly illogical. There's a moth here, it's joining me. And how true is that? That's why I said life doesn't make sense. We can get to a little bit this and a little bit here, a little further. A couple sentences here. Life itself has no rules. That is its mystery and its unknown law. What you call knowledge is an attempt to impose something comprehensible on life. He goes on a little further here. Carl Jung says, that all sounds very desolate, but nevertheless, it prompts me to disagree. His soul, you have nothing to disagree with. You are in the madhouse. And it goes on a little bit there. But that paragraph, be glad that you can recognize it, madness, for you will thus avoid becoming its victim. Madness is a special form of the spirit. And when he talks about spirit, he talks about that thing within us. You know? Not necessarily a religious spirit, but that spirit that what's been with us all through evolution, all the, you know, the deep down rooted stuff. Like I said, I'm not an expert, but I'm a layman here. Madness is a special form of spirit and clings to all teachings and philosophies, but even more to daily life, since life itself is full of craziness and at bottom utterly illogical. Man strives toward reason only so that he can make rules for himself. Life itself has no rules. And that's it right there. That is one of the core beliefs here of myself, of my channel, why I'm here. What I've learned from other folks. Life is chaos. There are no rules. The only rules that you know of are man-made. Even if it's your God, man made those. You may think God, well, I don't want to get into that, but too much of a political God, all this, but man wrote that. We can try to discuss whether or not God exists. I don't get into that, but I'm coming here to you as an agnostic, atheist, whatever you want to call me. I'm a human being. I don't like to attach myself to labels. I'm very, you know, just whatever. It doesn't matter to me if God does or does not exist. That doesn't matter to me. Life itself has no rules. When an asteroid is coming to Earth, it's just on its course because it, you know, it's where it's going. There's no rules, and it's going to hit impact. It's going to be chaos. The only rule, and the reason I'm saying that is because that's nature. That wind, there's no rules, natural rules, maybe as far as how the wind comes about. But that wind is free. We are as free as that wind. There's all the moths flying around here. You don't see these moths. There's no rules for them. There's no rules. There are no rules. We've created rules out of fear. Because we have, and out of fear, we need to control things so we can feel safe. Pretty sure you have rules, right, in your house, your household. That's to control, to make your life feel comfortable and safe. You are in control of the situation. Without no rules, without that control, it's scary. And we strive towards reason only so that we can make rules for ourselves. We want to understand everything so that we're not afraid, so that we can know more. Not all across the board. I don't want to make extreme arguments here. You know, let's be a little logical. I mean, we do search for things to outer space, not to create more rules, to search for life. But government, that's man-made, that's fantasy, that's ideas. There was no government before the human race existed. We created that. I've said this before, and this is a lot of stuff that I've just come to realize, but it's 100 years ago, you know, he was having this discussion with himself, trying to understand it. Friedrich Nietzsche, and you could probably go back to ancient Greece, the philosophers. We are no different than any other animal. They're more highly evolved. We have awareness, things like this. But there's no rules, there's no law. The only laws we have to obey, the laws of gravity, the only rules we have to obey are the rules of hunger and thirst. We can do whatever we want. I can choose to kill any organism for my own survival. I have that natural right. You have that natural right to select what things to eat. I enjoy eating everything. I've eaten some crickets. I eat the living organisms that are plants. I eat animals, fish. I like consuming everything because life has to offer. Just another animal eating a bunch of other organisms. That's all we are. Now we're getting off here on a tangent, but the plants eat the plants. Plants eat the bugs. Bugs eat the plants. Animals eat the plants. And the reason all these plants exist is because of all the dead things. All the other life has died, and those nutrients have gone into the soil. So plants feed off of the detritus, I guess you could say. I don't use that word too often, so I might correct me on that, but life feeds on life as its tool. Maynard wrote in his lyrics on the album Enema. I think it was from that album. I forget what song it was. Life is after the it's after the actually the final track. It's a hidden track, I think it's right. Life feeds on life, feeds on life, feeds on life. And there's no rules, there's no laws, but we've created that. We've created government. And the madness inside of us there's a lot of more to talk about, but the madness inside of us is the chaos. That kind of madness. Absolute chaos. That madness. That's where I'm saying that right now, just based on what I've read. There's a craziness, there's a madness inside us. It's just, you start to think about what are we, you know, what is consciousness, who are we, ego, superego, all these things. You know, we're just a biological machine. There's no soul. There's this spirit, there's this thing where all our memories are and our emotions are. We don't even know where's that stored at and how that all works. That's an ocean inside there, our minds. It's a universe inside there. And I don't mean that in a spiritual manner. I just mean all the synapses and where memories are stored and the emotions and how all that interacts and how you can see something and be triggered and react. And your mind goes through, I don't know how many terabytes of data that you've stored, your brain has stored, and you can just access that. It's like a quantum computer, a biological quantum computer, and there's that madness inside of us, there's that chaos inside of us. And that's what you see me. I'm trying to be as liberated as a human being as I possibly can. Because this is the only life that I have. And I think I've talked about this. I feel like I'm having like a deja vu moment here. So I probably talked about this before. This is the only shot I got. There's no afterlife. I don't know how many more years, months, days I have left. I'm in my mid-40s. Muhammad Ali lived for however long he did, and suffered with Parkinson's. Who do we lose this year? Jesus, drawing a blank. There's a couple folks that we, I forgot who we, it was a couple months ago. Ah, crazy. Anyway, my mind's gone. But, that's how I, that's why this video is, was made, because I was thinking about how we're in a madhouse, we're all crazy here, right? You see that on Facebook or Twitter. You always see that meme, whatever, that quote thrown around. Welcome to the madhouse, we're all crazy here. And here I am drawn to this. And here we are, you know? I don't want to get into too much about coincidences, but life itself has no rules. And our knowledge is us trying to understand life. And we understand life, yeah. We understand it scientifically, and we have some knowledge about how things work. That's our knowledge. Subjective through human eyes. It's our knowledge is just human based. Everything is subjective. The only way we can get close to the truth is intersubjectivity. It's when you get a whole lot of people that can look up at the sun and say, yeah, that's the sun. I'm sure you get everyone on the planet to say, that's the sun. what about everyone else on the other side of the planet when the sun is not out, but the moon has rotated, the earth has rotated, and they see the moon? Well, they don't see the sun. Well, the sun exists, right? It's rotating around, right? Does it, right? Sure it does, of course. Crazy not to think so. Crazy, right? But, we're all a little mad. Yeah, we are these free-willed, chaotic organisms that we can do whatever we please. But people don't like that. And they want to control us. Control you. Laws, government. And I understand that, I get that. We don't want to go around just acting like pirates, and raping and pillaging, and murdering and all this, even though it still goes on today. It'll probably go on for who knows how many more centuries, millennia. But so I was drawn to that. We still got about 20 minutes. I'd like to make a nice long video. So that's my subjective view. That's Carl Jung's subjective view. His internal discussions and exploring himself and trying to understand. And he did not want that published in his lifetime for fear of being ridiculed or not taken seriously. And all that ridicule, poking fun of people, making fun of people, not taking folks seriously, that's all subjective, that's all madness. We shouldn't be ashamed to say, do whatever we want. If someone gets offended, that's on them. Every single human being has the right to live however they want, say whatever they want, do whatever they want. We've created illogical rules that go against human nature. Like calling marijuana illegal. Trying to decide, put a law down that governs when human beings, when these animals can, when these monkeys can drink alcohol. What age? 16, 18, 21. All arbitrary numbers. Should a 6-year-old kid drink a beer? No. Of course not. 10-year-old? No. But that individual wants to. I'm not condoning anything illegal here. Let's just get that straight. But this is life. This is the truth. This is my truth. And this is Carl Jung's truth, Friedrich Nietzsche's truth, a lot of philosophers' truths. I can do what I want, say what I want, kill what I want, eat what I want, love what I want, be compassionate when I want, not care when I want. And nobody likes hearing that. It's not like, oh, look at me, I'm such a rebel. Nothing to do with that. Nothing to do with that at all. But that is, what human beings are. Free-willed creatures, organisms, animals, highly evolved animal. That's all we are. Nothing special about us besides the fact that we're highly evolved. Beyond that, you know. And that's not to make anyone... And again, that's my truth. That's my subjective view. There's probably a lot of folks that would agree with that. So you want to go back to that. I want to go back to that intersubjectivity. I was talking about the sun. Let's talk about Jesus or Buddha or any other deity. How many millions of people believe and have billions throughout the course of mankind believed in the God, Jesus? Let's just say Jesus or God, the Catholic, Christian God. Well, that's intersubjectivity. Let's just say 1 billion people in the world believe that a God exists. Does that mean it exists? That's 1 billion people. That's intersubjectivity. And there's 1 billion people that believe a God does not exist. No one's right, no one's wrong. That's what it comes down to. You know, this isn't to debate the existence of God and promote atheism or get anybody to convert. I mean, you've never heard me. Yes, I was raised Catholic, and I've made videos that have fun with Christianity because I can. It exists. Christianity is this thing here. This is you. If you're Christian, this is you, and you've elected to take this thing and incorporate it into your life. When I make fun of Christianity or make fun of Bic lighters just because you like them, just because you incorporate that into your life, doesn't mean I make fun of you. If I was to make fun of you, that's a different thing, but you have to learn how to not take things personally when it comes to things like that. And I'm not trying to make fun of Christianity in my videos. I'm not sitting here trying to talk about my videos and explain them. I'm just saying that how did I get on this topic? Intersubjectivity. Some people believe, you know, like I said, yeah, I'm not here to... you've never heard me say I've never seen a video, never hear me say you should become a Catholic, you should leave your religion. I say a lot of things that bring into question. I don't think it's something that you should believe in, but I'm never trying to convert anybody. You can do whatever you want. To each their own. And that's part of the reason that I'm here, is to try to get, especially kids, teens, that are raised struggling with identity, struggling with rules and so many messages. Do this, don't do that. Especially if they're being raised Catholic and going through what I went through, being bullied, and just trying to get a break free from the dogma. I'm going to reach those folks too. Not to convert anybody. But it's part of the reason I'm here. I was raised in a household. We had rules. You know, I understood a lot of those rules. Didn't agree with some of them. I took my religion into the ring. And we went toe-to-toe. We won 12 rounds, and I got bloodied over it. It was a fight. A lot of folks left their religion behind peacefully. Not me. Especially because I'm a highly sensitive person. I rebelled hard against my religion. Like I said, I took my religion toe-to-toe into the ring. We slugged it out. For years, for decades. I used to hate. Yeah, we're getting into a little religious thing here, aren't we? I don't want to avoid that, but... But so the intersubjectivity, that's the closest we can get to the truth. Is, having a lot of people come together and say, yes, this is a Bic lighter, I can feel it, it's plastic, it's blue. So that must be the truth. But, but again, it's a human experience. It's human beings trying to understand a world that was not created by human beings. And human beings, animals, monkeys, highly evolved monkeys, instilling rules on each other. And you can't do that. And that causes a lot of problems. Why is society as screwed up as it is? Because we're trying to control people. You can't control people. What you need is education, compassion. You definitely need those things. Some semblance of civilization, yeah, definitely. But, the reason the world is, the human race is like it is and always will be, is that madness inside of us. That chaos, the madness of the world. Now, I'm not really sure if that's the type of madness that Carl Jung was talking about. I didn't really read beyond that, and I'm not a student of him. But I'm pretty sure I'm sort of close. We're all crazy. Not crazy like, you know. That we're not logical, and we think that lizard people run the United States government or all that, although they probably do, but just we're all a little mad. And it's great. The only reason why I wanted to share that was because it's validation that it's more than just a quote. We're all crazy here. Carl Jung, another human being, prolific, creative, just genius in his own right. Call him crazy all you want. It don't matter to me. Because my truth is, I don't see him as crazy. Rest in peace. But, I just lost my train of thought. And we're winding down here anyway, so... But yeah, it's validation that this prolific human being was on a journey of self-discovery. To try to understand himself and his life and the world more. And I was thinking those thoughts, and here's that little passage, and it's just like, we're all seeking that validation in some way or another. So we're not feeling alone with our thoughts. Am I the only one that thinks this way? I must be crazy. No. Yeah, we're all crazy. That's why the world is like it is. Tell me, how does it make any sense when we destroy forests and put up these skyscrapers, and then on that same street we have a sign that says, do not litter. Human beings are a paradox, a walking contradiction of themselves. Hypocrites. Everyone's a hypocrite. If you don't want to be a hypocrite, you need to live in a cave without any clothes. Just think about every single thing around us and every single person behind it. The person that built it, the company, who built the companies, the building, all the people involved, how they vote. I mean, there's... I mentioned this before in a podcast a little bit, but we're all hypocrites. If I wanted to be, let's say I was a vegan, well, I'm a hypocrite. Let's say, oh, you know, all this, I'm against animals and all this. Well, you know, who made this shirt? I'm sure there's a meat eater that made this shirt. Maybe he was a packaged it. Maybe he worked at a factory that makes the boxes. And here there's a meat eater involved in a company, an employee that makes these letters. I'm only saying meat eater and vegan thing, because a lot of folks seem to have an issue with that. Don't understand, doesn't make any sense. You can eat whatever you want in this world. People's right. People can do what they want to do. But yeah, let's say I'm a staunch Republican, right? And I hate Democrats. Let's say I'm a diehard Christian. And I feel a certain way about atheists. Well, how do you know atheist or a Democrat wasn't involved in the making or delivery or this, or working at the customer service for this company, or this table, or this citronella candle, or this camera? What about your internet connection? What about the power that it takes to power that internet connection? Think before you begin to judge anybody and try to be holier than thou. I know we're getting off on a little bit of a tangent here, but I'll be saying that for quite a while, because a lot of folks try to be holier than thou and live and force their beliefs on others, and they're hypocrites. Because you're supporting, even if it's indirectly, you're supporting things that go against what it is that you preach. And that's why you can't preach. Just live. Just live. Do what you want. Let others do what they want. Live how they want. And that's it. You don't like the fact that someone wants to help make and improve the life of the homeless, and save the trees, you know? No, that's too bad. People are allowed to do that. And it gets more complicated than that, because the people that want to save the trees, well, they go up against the people that own the laws and protection of the government. They can build wherever they want to build, but anyway. Human race, welcome to the madhouse. We're all crazy here. And that genius, prolific human being, Carl Jung, hit it right on the head. All right, that's it, I'm out. Thank you for joining me. I wish you all my very best on your path in life. I really do. And thanks for being with me here, however many years it's been, months, days. Thanks for your support if you're a patron, whether it's a one-time, a dollar, whether it's been $10 every month for a couple years, I appreciate that. And I hope that I continue to, experience this crazy life together for many years to come. All right, take care of yourself, and I'll see you in another video real soon. Bye-bye.